week on Monday, we celebrated International Women's Day. On this occasion, Kamala Harris, the first US female vice president, urged European leaders to build a world that works for women as she addressed the European Parliament, a symbolic yet significant appearance for a new transatlantic agenda. Just before the opening of the plenary session on Monday, Parliament marked 2021 International Women's Day, focusing on women's empowerment and leadership during the COVID-19 pandemic. In her speech, Kamala Harris underlined that women need to have an equal voice in decision-making. She concluded that if we build a world that works for women, our nations will be safer, stronger, and more prosperous. The celebration ended with a speech by Commission President Ursula von der Leyen, in which she announced that last week the Commission set a new target for Europe to cut the gender employment gap by half. Additionally, the Commission required that all member states put women at the center of the post-COVID-19 recovery plans. On a different but equally important topic, this week the representatives of the European Commission welcomed another high-level US representative, the US Climate Award John Kerry. 7 weeks into the Biden's presidency, the revived Transatlantic Climate Alliance is already in full strength, trying to shift the commitments of the world's largest polluter. The meeting came only a few days after China announced a 5-year plan that analysts say would see its emissions rise. The EU and US committed for a joint effort to get China to cut its emissions and are lobbying Beijing to avert. Ahead of the UN climate talks in November, the EU and US want China to shift its commitments to peak emissions from 2030 to 2025 and to end coal power investments at home and abroad. As expressed by John Kerry, Glasgow is the last, best opportunity that we have and the best hope that the world will come together and build on Paris Agreement.